Harold Peary Show. And now, Harold Peary, as Honest Harold, the homemaker. Well, Honest Harold, the homemaker, has a new problem on his hands these days. His lazy young cousin, Raymond, who has come to visit him from Chicago. However, Saturday is a day of leisure for Harold, and we find him feeling pretty satisfied with himself this morning. He has finally talked Raymond into looking for a job. Right now, Harold is just finishing dressing before going into breakfast.
Oh, whistle while you work, whistle while you work. Well, this new plaid vest looks pretty good. Harold, you're quite a fellow. There was a young man from the West who loved a young lady with zest. So hard did he press her to make her say yes, sir, that he broke 3 cigars in his vest. feel fine today. Dear little cousin Raymond. Finally got him out looking for a job. I guess that pep talk I gave him last night turned the trick. I felt a little sorry for him, though, when I heard his alarm go off at 7 this morning. Yeah, but the boy has got to learn that the early bird gets the worm. Oh, whistle while you work. La-da-da-da-da-da-dee. Cousin Raymond's gone to work.
Good morning, son. You sound cheerful.
Yeah, good morning, Mother. I am. Yeah, I guess we won't have to worry about Cousin Raymond loafing around the house anymore. Let's see, it's 9 a.m. I'll bet that boy's got a job by now.
Well, I don't think so, Harold.
Why not?
He's still in bed.
Mother, I heard his alarm go off.
Yes, but I don't think he did.
That's the last straw. I'll go wake him up.
Now be gentle with him, Harold.
Yeah, I'll be gentle with him. He's going to look for a job this morning if I have to carry him downtown in his pajamas. Raymond, I want... Oop. Look at him saw wood. That's the closest he's come to working since he's been here. Raymond, wake up. Sounds like a B-29. Maybe I'd better try shaking him. Raymond, wake up. Raymond, it's morning. Cock-a-doodle-doo. Raymond, the house is burning down. Yeah, I know. I'll tickle his feet. I'll just lift the covers up here. Oop, sleeps with his socks on. And they're mine.
Kitchy-kitchy-coo, Raymond. Kitchy-kitchy-coo.
Won't even wake up to laugh. By George, I know something that'll wake him up. Mother, it's too bad Raymond won't wake up. Dorothy Lemoore's on the phone.
She is. Where?
I got you.
Oh, hi, cuz.
Yeah, hiya. You get out of that bed, young man. You promised me you'd get up early this morning and look for a job, and here it is, 9 o'clock.
Yeah, it is kind of late. Maybe I'd better wait and look for a job tomorrow.
Raymond, you're not going to put this off any longer.
But I don't know where to look, cuz.
Oh, well, it's customary to look through the want ads. I got a paper right here. Never mind, I'll do it for you. And don't go to sleep. Let's see. Help wanted male. Accountant, auto mechanic, boy wanted. Ah, must be ambitious, alert, wide awake. Better try another one. Let's see here. Here's just a job for you. Listen to this. Wanted, delivery boy, apply Schroeder's grocery store. Sounds like just the thing.
Yeah.
Salary, 25 a week, must drive automobile.
Oh, that's too bad, cuz. I can't take the job.
Why not?
I haven't got a driver's license.
Oh, yeah? Well, I got news for you. You can get one at the town marshal's office, and I'm going to escort you down there, and right now.
But I'm not dressed.
You got a good start with my new socks on. Hurry up. There's Pete the marshal behind the desk. Pete, I want to talk to you.
All right, Harold. What can I do for you?
I want to get a driver's license here for my cousin.
Oh, yes. Your cousin from Chicago. Howdy, boy.
Hello.
Pete, will you get a move on? Raymond wants that license today.
All right. First, I got to test his vision. Mm-hmm. Now, where did I put that eye chart? Oh, Shaw.
Haven't you got an eye chart?
I just remembered the boys at the firehouse borrowed it for a dartboard. Well, it don't matter. We'll just use this calendar here on the wall.
Calendar?
Back up, son.
All right.
All right, now I'll test your vision. See this picture on the calendar? George Washington crossing the Delaware.
Yes.
How many men in the boat?
12.
Correct. Now, who's that fella standing up?
Everybody knows that is George Washington.
No coaching, Harold.
You.
All right, now we'll try the words on the calendar. What's this word?
Monday.
Correct. What's the next one?
Tuesday.
And the next one?
Wednesday.
That boy has got eyes like a hawk, Harold.
Oh, brother, what an eye test. Pete, let's get this thing over with. I'm trying to get Raymond a job.
All right, now. Now, Raymond, I'll have to give you the oral test. That means spoken, Harold.
No kidding.
First question. Raymond, suppose you wanted to make a left turn, and you had your hand out, and Harold's car pulls up at the intersection. Who has the right-of-way?
I do.
You do not. Anybody knows I'd have the right-of-way.
Not if the boy had reached the intersection first. Harold, how did you ever get a driver's license?
Well, I passed this driver's test 6 years ago.
6 years ago? Got news for you, boy. Your license has expired. Gotta give you the test, too, boy.
But, Pete...
Ready? All right, now, look at this picture on the counter. Who's that man standing up in the boat?
Calvin Coolidge.
You need glasses, boy.
Gosh, Raymond, it's after 10 o'clock. I thought we'd never get away from Pete.
Yeah.
Well, anyhow, I'm glad you passed your driving test, Raymond.
Thanks. Too bad you didn't pass yours.
That'll do, Raymond. I'll pass it tomorrow. Oh, there's Schroeder's grocery store. You can pull up in front there.
All right.
Now, look, Raymond. I know you can get this job if you really go after it. And remember, first impressions are very important. Now, when you go in to ask Mr. Schroeder for the job, what are you going to say to him?
Mr. Schroeder, you don't want to hire me as the delivery boy, do you?
No, Raymond, you got to sell yourself. Be dynamic. Don't take no for an answer. If he tries to stall you, put your foot down.
Put my foot down?
Yeah.
All right, cuz. I will. I'll be right back.
Guess I finally woke Raymond up. Yes, sir. This may be the beginning of a whole career for Raymond. He'll go in and get this job. He'll be a delivery boy for a while. Then he'll get promoted to clerk. Then banana buyer. Then manager. And eventually he'll own the store. Someday he'll be president of a whole chain of grocery stores. We'll get all our groceries wholesale. Our little Raymond, a captain of industry.
I'm back, cuz.
Raymond, did you get the job, my boy?
Nope.
What? What happened?
Well, I put my foot down like you told me, but I stuck it in a case of eggs. Schroeder chased me out of the store.
He did?
He said he's going to charge the eggs to you.
Come on, Raymond, we'll look someplace else. Raymond, we've been all over town. This is our last chance to get you a job.
Yeah.
Funny, I didn't think of this before. Hiring you as my assistant at the radio station. Now, you can help me on my 9 to 10 homemakers program.
9 to 10? Uh-huh. Oh, I like those hours.
Yeah. Raymond, we work all day preparing the program.
Oh. What's my day off?
For heaven's sake, you haven't even got the job yet. Now, I'll go in and talk to the manager, Stanley Peabody.
Oh, yeah.
Station KHJP. I'll connect you.
Oh, there's Gloria. Hi, babe.
Hi, Raymond.
Good morning, Gloria.
Oh, good morning, Harold.
Mr. Peabody in?
Guess what, Gloria? I'm going to work here.
You are? Oh, that's wonderful, Raymond.
Yeah.
Why, we can go to lunch together every day.
Gloria, is Mr.
Peabody... And Raymond, we can go out in the afternoon and get an ice cream cone.
Well, what flavor ice cream do you like, Gloria? Chocolate?
No, Raymond.
Strawberry?
No, Raymond.
Pistachio?
No, Raymond.
Banana nut?
No, Raymond.
Cut that out.
Gloria, will you please ask me if Mr. Peabody's in?
No, Raymond. Oh, yes, he is, Harold.
Thank you.
Peppermint stick?
No, Raymond.
Oh, my goodness.
No, Raymond. Tutti Frutti?
No, Raymond.
Those kids. Breeze, they're a man with soul so dead who never said I should have stood in bed.
Let me see. How can I handle this now? Well, I'll just tell Peabody he can hire Raymond as my assistant, or I'll take my program elsewhere. Yeah, that'll throw a scare into him.
Yeah?
Hello, Stanley. May I come in?
You are in.
Yes. Stanley, I wanted to...
Quiet. Can't you see I'm drinking my yogurt?
Yes, sir. He's so sour the yogurt ought to be drinking him. Look at his Adam's apple go up and down. Looks like a turkey that swallowed a yo-yo.
There.
You didn't finish it, Stanley. There's some in your tie.
Never mind. What is it, Hemp?
Well, Stanley, I wanted to ask a little favor of you.
What's that?
I think I need a little help on my program.
You certainly do.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard it every day this week, and the only time I liked it was this morning.
Wait a minute. This is Saturday. My program wasn't on the air this morning.
That's why I liked it.
What a sneaky thing to say.
Honest, Harold, the homemaker. I don't see how the housewives stand your program with all those corny jokes.
Corny jokes?
Yes. Like the one you did yesterday on your gasoline commercial. How do you make Auntie Freeze take away her pajamas?
My mother liked it.
Well, I didn't.
The musicians liked it. Did you like the one about the butcher who put sawdust in the sausage because he couldn't make both ends meet?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. But I'm glad you came in. There's something I've been wanting to tell you for a long time.
Oh?
Hemp, unless your program gets inspired, you're going to find out you'll be fired.
Say, that rhymes. Whoop. Fired.
Yes. Now, what was the favor you wanted to ask me? Well, say something.
Violets are blue, roses are red. I think I'll leave while I'm ahead. Goodbye, Stanley. Mother, I'm home.
Oh, hello, Harold. Would you like a glass of milk and a cookie?
Yeah, thank you, Mother, but I'm not hungry.
Oh, Harold, Dr. Yancey phoned a while ago.
Oh? What did the old horse doctor want?
I told him you were down trying to find Raymond a job, and he said he'd let you know if he got any ideas.
Well, I'm not going to hold my breath. What are we going to do with Raymond, Mother? He's 22 years old, and he hasn't gotten anywhere.
Well, after all, Harold, he's just starting at the bottom.
Yeah, trouble is he likes it so well it looks like he's planning to stay there.
Oh, Harold.
Uh-oh. There's Doc and his horse and buggy. Oh, my goodness. Got the only buggy in town with a Stanley steamer horn.
Harold! Oh, Harold!
Okay, Doc, I'm coming. Look at Doc's old horse, Silver Moon. She gets more sway-backed every day.
Come here, Harold.
Why don't you come in the house, Doc?
Why, Harold, I couldn't leave Silver Moon out here all by herself. Could I, dear?
Oh, brother.
Of course, I could unhitch her and bring her in the house.
Never mind. What do you want, Doc?
Well, Harold, I understand your cousin's trying to find a job.
Well, that's not exactly right.
Well, your worries are over. I got just the thing for him.
You have? What is it?
Yes, sir. Old Doc Yancey has come through again.
Doc, what's the job?
Yes, sir. When you're lost in a snowdrift and don't know which way to turn, who comes to the rescue? Doc Yancey, that faithful old Saint Bernard.
You look like a Saint Bernard.
Oh, thank you, Harold.
Doc, will you please stop taking bows before you fall out of the buggy?
Well, of course, Harold, if you don't want me to tell you what it is.
Doc, believe me, I do want you to tell me.
Well, all right, then I'll climb up here in the buggy so I can exercise Silver Moon.
Oh, my goodness.
That's it, huh? Giddy up, Silver Moon. Come on.
Now, what's the job you got for Raymond?
Well, it's not a job exactly. It's a profession.
Huh?
The noblest profession of them all. A veterinarian.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Doc. We want to find Raymond a job now.
Well, it only takes 4 years to go through veterinarian college.
It's 4 years. Then what would he be? A horse doctor.
Now you've gone and hurt her feelings, Harold. It's all right. He didn't mean it, Silver Moon.
Oh, my goodness. Doc, we don't want Raymond to be an old man before he goes to work.
Oh, sir, I tell you, there's no thrill like being a veterinarian. Why, you walk down the street, you see a cat, and you say to yourself, I brought her into the world. And then when you get an emergency call in the middle of the night from an Airedale with a warm nose, and you go out and you hold her paw.
Oh, Doc!
And those glorious years I spent at veterinary college. I'll never forget our alma mater song. We will miss those dear old dogwood trees. Woof, woof, woof. Where we look for fleas on Pekingese. Woof, woof, woof.
Dog.
Farewell to those distemper pills.
Why don't you take one yourself? Let me out of here. I'm going home. One buggy ride I'm glad to walk home from. And Doc. And look for fleas on Pekingese. Probably got a couple on me after riding in that buggy. Wanting Raymond to be a veterinarian. Well, I give up. I'll never find that boy a job.
Is that you, cuz?
Raymond, you're up.
Harold, I found a job.
Huh?
Yes, I did.
Hey, wait a minute, Raymond. Let me sit down. I've had a hard day. Huh. You say you've got a job?
Well, not exactly, but I just saw an ad in the afternoon paper.
Oh, let me see the ad. Wanted, ballroom dance instructor. Male, Theodore's Academy of the Dance. What's this? Easy work, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday off.
This is just the kind of job I've always wanted.
Yeah, I can understand that.
I think I'll go down there right now.
Just a moment, Raymond. That ad sounds like a racket to me.
Oh, gee, cuz, this was my chance to do an honest day's work.
Honest day's work? Well, I'll tell you what I'll do, Raymond. I'll go down there with you and investigate this thing. If it sounds all right, you can apply for the job.
Oh, thanks, cuz. Gosh, I'm a dance instructor. Charleston, Charleston, da-da-da-da-dee-dee.
Da-da-da-da. Oh, come on, will you?
I go in with you, cuz?
No, Raymond. You wait right here in the car. It won't take me long to find out if this dance academy is on the square.
Okay, cuz.
Theodora's Academy of the Dance. Look at all these pictures in the reception room. Who's that in the bell-bottom trousers? Oh, Rita Hayworth. Guess Theodora's in the other room there. Giving some sucker a tango lesson. Uh-oh, here she comes.
Well, a dance lover.
Huh?
Welcome to Theodora's Academy of the Dance.
Oh, thank you. Miss Theodora.
What kind of dancing lessons are you interested in?
Well, I...
Don't tell me. Let me guess. Let's see. I would say you're the Latin type. Long sideburn.
I just need a haircut, I guess.
I can just see you doing a languorous tango like this. Step and step, glide, and keep your back straight.
Miss.
Step and step, glide. Don't watch your feet, please.
Feet?
Step.
But, miss, just a minute. I don't want
to. Oh, you look like a good Kong material, too.
Oh?
One and two and three, kick.
Oop,
one
miss.
And two and three, kick.
Oop,
one
miss.
One and two and three, kick.
Will you please light somewhere? I want to talk to you.
Of course.
I didn't come here for dancing lessons. You see, I saw your ad in the paper for a dance instructor.
Oh, of course, you're applying for the job.
What?
Lucky Theodora. I didn't dream you'd be so charming.
But, miss, you don't get...
Who would have thought Melrose Springs had such handsome men?
Yeah, well, you...
Well, there are a few of us, I guess.
And where did you get those beautiful brown eyes? I'm sure you'll enjoy the job. Good salary. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday off. Why, it almost sounds too good to be true, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. That's what I wanted to talk to you about. You see, my...
Why don't we go into the ballroom?
Ballroom?
Yes. I'll have to try you out, you know.
But,
We'll have a cozy little dance together.
Cozy little dance?
Yes. Come on, brown eyes.
Honest Harold, why don't you tell her what you came here for? Well, in no hurry. Won't hurt to have one cozy little dance first. Brown eyes. Coming, Theodora.
Oh, there you are.
Yeah, here I am.
I suppose you're familiar with the different dance steps, the rumba, the samba, the mamba.
The hoomba?
Which one shall we do?
Well, how about a waltz?
A waltz?
Yeah.
All right. I'll put on a record.
Gosh, Theodora looks awfully cute in that dress. Guess that's what they call an off-the-shoulder organ, D.
There we are. Well, aren't you going to put your arms around me?
Put my arms around you?
Yes. If we're going to dance.
Oh, dance. All right.
That's it.
Hope my hand isn't too cold on your back.
Oh, I don't mind. Cold hands, warm heart.
This is nice.
Yes. Shall we start to dance now?
Of course. Well, here goes. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three.
Why, you're a beautiful waltzer.
Can't count very well, though. No, I'm not bad, I guess. I did win second prize last year at the Moose Costume Ball.
Really?
Yeah. I'd have won first prize, but it was kind of hard to dance in that moose suit.
You know, you haven't told me your name yet.
Oh, Harold Moose. I mean, Harold Hemp.
Harold?
Yeah.
I could follow you better if you held me a little closer.
Closer? All right.
Harold?
Hmm?
Mind if I put my head on your shoulder?
Oh, of course not.
Oh, there.
You're up, sweeps, tickling my nose.
That's nice. Your voice has a lot of timber.
Timber? Well, I used to work in a lumber camp. Oh, if you were the only girl in the world, and I were the only boy, nothing else would matter in the world today. We could go on loving in the same old way. A garden of Eden just meant for two.
with nothing to mar our joy. I would say such wonderful things to you. There would be such wonderful things to do. If you were the only girl in the world, and I were the only boy.
That was wonderful.
Thank you. It was wonderful dancing with you, too.
Of course, if you take the job as my dance instructor, we'll be waltzing together a lot. Every night.
We will? When do I go to work?
Right away.
Yeah?
Oh, I should tell you the salary is only $25 a week.
Oh, that's all right.
And, oh, yes, you'll have to take a brush-up course for a month or two.
Brush-up course?
Yes, all instructors do that. And it will only cost you $35 a week.
$35 a week?
Yes. But don't forget, your salary is $25.
Oh, yeah. Then all I have to pay you is $10 a week.
That's right.
Hey, that's a real bargain. Thank you very much.
Sure, you don't mind.
Mind? No, it's a pleasure.
Harold.
Hmm?
The $10 is payable in advance.
Hmm? Oh, of course. There you are. Two fives.
Thank you.
Theodora. How about starting my brush-up course now, huh?
All right, we'll try a conga.
Yeah?
Follow me.
Yeah?
One and two and three, kick.
One and two and three, kick. One and two and three, kick.
Hey, cuz!
Oh, Raymond, forgot all about him.
Excuse me, Theodora. What do you want, Raymond?
Cuz, did I get the job?
No, Raymond, I did.
What? Why can't I have it?
My boy, you couldn't afford this job.
Why?
Never mind. Go home, Raymond. Here's a dollar.
That's it.
Who was that, Harold?
Just a boy. Come on, Theodora. One and two and three, kick. One and two and three, kick. Whee, this is a swell job, and it's only going to cost me $10 a week.
You have just heard the Harold Peary Show, Honest Harold, who returns in just a moment with an important announcement. The supporting players tonight included Jane Morgan, William Tracy, Parley Bear, Olin Soule, and Mari Alden. And featured Gloria Holliday as Gloria and Joseph Kearns as old Doc Yak Yak. Norman McDonald directed, and the music was composed and conducted by Jack Meekin. Honest Harold, created by Harold Peary, was written by Gene Stone and Jack Robinson. Now back to Harold Peary.
Bob? Our joyful laughing lady, the winner of the Honest Harold Laugh Contest, has been chosen. She'll be flown to Los Angeles via TWA Constellation, arriving here Thursday, and will appear with us on our show Wednesday, November 22nd, to demonstrate how and why she won the contest. Over 50,000 women have chortled, guffawed, and chuckled all over the nation. But the winner is Mrs. Lena Duncan of 210 Stooksbury Street, Knoxville, Tennessee. Congratulations, Mrs. Duncan. See you next week, folks, when Mrs. Duncan, or Miss Mirthquake of 1950, as she'll be known, will be with us. Good night.
Now stay tuned for Bob Crosby and Tony Arden as Bing Crosby's guests on The Bing Crosby Show, which follows immediately on most of these same CBS stations. Bob Lamond speaking. This is CBS, where the dramas of the lineup are heard every Thursday evening. The Columbia Broadcasting System.